Well, hello YouTube and greetings from the Republic of Texas once again. I know it's kind of weird to have a swimming pool video being posted in the month of January, but I wanted to show you another little idea that I had. At the end of the season this year, which in Texas is the end of October, I think our last swim was the second week in October, and then it was time to shut this thing down and get ready for the winter. I just didn't have the energy to drain it, clean it, fold it up, and put it away. So I decided I was going to winter the thing this year. And what I decided to do was I tried to cover it. And I'm going to talk about that. I'm going to make this a short video just to kind of give you an idea. But I tried the solar cover that came with the pool, and it actually forms down into the water level. And within a week, it was full of leaves and branches and just all kinds of debris that had been blown over there. And I just didn't want to mess with that. So I decided to try to make kind of a tent for the thing that would allow the water to run off of the sides of the pool. And it worked. And you can see down here towards the bottom, I've got some kind of straps or some string holding it down, kind of keeping it tight. In the middle, I took the ladder and just stuck that right in the center of the pool, and that's what's giving it its shape. And so I just kind of pulled the tarp tight to kind of make that umbrella to have everything run off. Well, it worked fine for about a week or two, and then when we got some pretty heavy rain, big puddles would form here, and it would pull the stakes out of the ground and would not let it, it wouldn't drain. So I was scooping water off. That didn't work. It was just going to be a pain. I wanted something that was going to be kind of hassle-free. So what I finally ended up doing is I just took a knife, and where all the water was filling these areas, I just took and put kind of a cross hole in there. And so what this is doing is this is just letting the water drain into the pool, which is fine. And all the leaves and stuff kind of blow off. Now there's still some debris that gets down inside the pool, but for the most part, it's been keeping it pretty clean. Some of you may have questions on how I winterized the pool, chemicals and things. I didn't really do a lot. I threw a chlorine tablet in the floater, and it's just kind of in there moving around and distributing chlorine. I did add a little bit of water hardness increaser to maintain that level, and I really, that's just about it. I got the pH of the pool pretty accurate right at the end of the season, and I just kind of let it go. I've taken the cover off of this once or twice just to kind of look and see what's in there, and there is a little bit of debris in this area, but it's going to be really easy to clean up when the season starts again, probably around mid-April for us, and I'll get this thing up and going. But I was concerned that the ring was going to deflate because of the temperature change. We've had about a week of this is really the first nice day that we've had. We've had about a week of below freezing wind chills down into the teens, and so I was kind of concerned that the pump and the hoses might freeze. And so what I did was I just let the pump run 24 hours a day when it was below freezing, and I checked the temperature of the pool to see what it was when we were down that low, and it was in the 40s. The temperature of the water was in the 40s, so keeping that water moving through those hoses won't let it freeze. If we have another really cold snap, I'm probably going to try to do some kind of insulation, or I might even pull the pump and the hoses off and get everything drained out and just leave the pool and just let it freeze. But anyway, I wanted to give you kind of what the winter swimming pool operation schedule is. And that's really just about it. So if this works for you, I appreciate any comments that you have. But anyway, there's the big idea that I had.